Hey, and welcome to MSU's Foundation Seed Program. My name is Doug Holen. I'm the manager of the Foundation Seed Program here with MSU. I've been in this position for about, well, this will be my fifth growing season. I've been aware of it pretty much my whole career and was looking forward to getting into this. Right now, we are in the seed house at the Post Farm just west of Bozeman. And this is the facility where everything kind of starts and finishes. Our goal, of course, our mission statement is to take the new varieties that the breeders are developing, expand and increase that seed, and get it out to the Montana seed growers, who then can get it out to the farming population of Montana. And that pretty much starts right here. The way things go traditionally is working with the winter wheat breeding program, spring wheat, the barley, the pulse crops, and the durum. Is those breeders, once a variety is approved and recommended in January of each year, they will produce the breeder seed out here at the Post Farm, and then they will bring me that seed in the fall. It'll come to this seed house. You're looking at anywhere from 15 to 40 bushels of that. That is all of the seed of that variety that there is. That's where it starts. We'll get that in here, we'll put it through our cleaning process, and then we'll put that in the ground. And that's our first year of foundation seed production. That's the beginning point. And then after that harvest, we can start getting it out to those seed growers. And so you can see behind me here, this is our finished product. So it's, again, starts and finishes in here. We typically, everything we send out is in 40 bushel totes. We can make arrangements for 20, 30, but typically everything's in increments of 40 bushel. And it'll go out in these, and we'll use semis to move that around based on orders around the state. Again, our first and primary goal is to produce this seed for the Montana producers, but we also are moving seeds, especially of our forage varieties, to Nebraska, North Dakota, South Dakota, Wyoming, Utah, Idaho, Oregon, probably about 7 or 8 different states that we'll go to after we get everything settled in Montana first. But we also, this is where the cleaning process begins when we have harvest. It's where the treating process is. Again, loading and distributing is all going to take place from here. We are now in the cleaning plant side of the seed house. They're connected. We're at the Post Farm. And I've said this many times over the years at field days all over the state. If anyone ever wants to stop and see how this operation runs, they're more than welcome to do that. We're typically always around. You'll find me here before the office. But this is where the operation starts. We've done a lot of renovating here in the last, I'd say, 8-9 months to get this whole plant up and more current than it was. So we've added this machine here, and this is where it starts. It's the debearder. So we run everything there from the grain truck, goes into the pit, and then it's going to come over to our Crippen, which is our main cleaning machine. And again, it's old, but it does exactly what it's supposed to do. It'll run through there. We're very fortunate, and most of our fields are very, very clean, so we don't have a lot of problems managing weed seed. We're just trying to get cracks and brokens and getting a quality product at the end. Something that we have added just very recently, we haven't even used it yet, we're waiting for the electrical connections, is we have a gravity table. And that is so, now that we're into the pulse component of foundation seed, we needed to add another machine. The gravity table has been delivered, of course. It was donated by the Montana Seed Growers Board of Directors, and something that we'll use here in probably a month or so as we harvest our first safflower and sandfoin and alfalfa here, and we'll run it across that. But a lot of renovations in here, lighting projects, ventilation projects. We've added machines. We've added a lot of catwalks and safety features with rails, just getting it up to date and something that's more efficient. We can also now load outside with our clean product, which we couldn't do before. Again, just a lot of efficiencies that we've been able to bring in, and a much safer environment. With the Foundation Seed Program, we have, it's just a couple people. I've got two students that I typically have working for us from the department, and they're seasonal, but we get some new ones every year for that. The idea is to foster profession and make sure we can replace people like myself. But it's a lot of teamwork. a lot of teamwork. And we're out at the Fort Ellis location right now, and we've got foundation fields pretty much all over the state. Most of them are located around Bozeman. We've got here Fort Ellis, Museum of the Rockies on campus, the Marsh Lab, which is on campus, the Post Farm, of course. We've got 40 acres we use right outside of Rosars on Huffine, and we got a big farm, the Lutz Farm, that's north of Bozeman. So those locations are set up to, with the rotations, for foundation seed production, working with the breeders, with the researchers, and our professionals at the Post Farm, Dave Gettle and Jeff Todd, are very good at setting this stuff up so that we're hitting the standards, but we're getting a good quality product at the end. This year, we're running about 170 acres of foundation seed. I should also point out we got close partnerships with the Eastern Ag Research Center in Sydney, the Central Research Center in Moccasin, and Northern up in Haver. They've been raising foundation seed for many, many years, and that allows us the opportunity to have a couple different locations in case we have some Mother Nature things that happen in one site. But we're out here, and what we have in the background is Dagmar. That is the new release for the spring wheat out of Luther Talbert's program. Luther, of course, is retired now. This is the last variety while he was still in. And this one is a semi-solid. It's got the yield of Vita. It's also got increased protein, more of a landing type protein. Again, semi-solid. But this is we got a field here, another 9 acres field just around the bend behind me, and a small field up at the Research Center in Haver as well. But this is a first seed produced of Dagmar. We've got orders for that. We'll start getting that out here next spring. And so we have the field here. On the other side is some landing. But again, this is where the fields start, how we work them, get them ready for inspection, harvest, and then get them over to that seed house and cleaning plant and get them out. It's very beneficial for the foundation seed program to be nestled in with the university. Every state has programs exactly like what we do. I shouldn't say exactly, but they have the same foundation seed. Some of them are independent, some of them are somewhat connected to universities. MSU has a big advantage in that this program is actually part of the plant pathology, science department under the College of Ag and the MAES. And so get to have a real close working relationship with all those researchers and faculty. Where we are now is out at the Lutz Farm, which is about 7 miles north of Bozeman. And as this farm gets more and more developed, we've shifted most of our foundation seed production out here. It works very well for that and in our rotations, but we can have larger fields of these varieties as well. What we're standing into is the winter wheat. We've got Bobcat, one of our newest winter wheat varieties, probably the hottest one that's come through for many years. It's the soft fly variety that we produced foundation seed of it last year, so this is the second year, so it'll be starting getting out to producers probably this fall from those seed houses. Behind us is 406, which is a couple years not too old. It's the newer Yellowstone with reduced height. And then straight ahead of me is a 20-acre field of Flathead, which is really MSU winter wheat's first early variety that we've released. Again, everything Yellowstone with some reduced height, but early is the novel trait that variety has. On the other side of the farm, we also have our Ray winter wheat. We've been producing that foundation seed now for 3 years, and that is the newer forage winter wheat. It's a dual purpose, so it can be for forage. It's very good for forage, but it also can be taken for grain if conditions allow or if markets allow for that. It is designed to be the replacement for Willow Creek, which we're still producing a very little bit about, but we think that this Ray will be what we're going to move on to in the future. With that, I should mention that the Foundation Seed Program has a website, and you can go to it, just call it up, buy that. It'll click pretty close to the top. You can see all the varieties that we're growing. There's some links on there that'll take you to variety descriptions. So any of these that are MSU, either current, old, upcoming as they're being released. You can go onto those websites and read about them, what the traits have, what the data says about them across the state. And so I invite you to do that. Any questions or comments, I'm always open. Anywhere you call, you'll get forwarded to my cell phone, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.